month, I didn't quite comprehend that it was going to be this thing where everybody around the world was going to watch it. Everybody was around the world was going to say, oh, you know, what a wonderful Cinderella story. When I was about 8, my mom put myself and my younger sister and pushed us to the South China Sea and basically said, may the goddess of mercy take you to safety and your destiny.
From Oliver Stone, director of Platoon and born on the 4th of July, comes the third film in an extraordinary trilogy. Heaven and Earth. The true story of one woman's journey to freedom.
My family lived in the village of Gala, in the shadow of the mountain, in the time before the war. I remember working beside my mother in the field, each grain of rice a symbol of life never wasted. When the soldiers came, I fought to keep my village and my family from being torn apart.
We are the soldiers of liberation! Help us win this war, and you get to keep your property and everything else you love.
In the face of fear, in the midst of betrayal, I struggle to remain strong. As I watch my world change forever, I remember my father's compassion.
Right is only the goodness you carry in your heart. Love for your ancestors, for your family. Wrong is all that comes between you and the love.
I met a man whose kindness made me forget the past.
This is Mom's 8th dog. She has the 8 ugliest dogs in the United States.
He wanted me to be his wife, to take me to his home in America. But in America, I was forced to fight once again.
You told me 2 years. We agreed, not one.
No.
To make a home for my children. And help my husband find his peace. Through it all, I have found strength in my father's wisdom to let go of the past and forgive, to hold on to love at all costs, and to never surrender my freedom. This is the war I have fought. This is the victory I have won.
Joan Chen. Tommy Lee Jones, Academy Award winner Hang Noor, and introducing Hepti Lee as Laylee Hayslip. Peace is not the end of war. Between a man and a woman. Between heaven and earth.
You start off with a game plan.
There's logic in making things happen now, especially if now there are things out there that are necessary. And I'm not here to tell anybody what they should do with their money. If you make your money, you do what you want with it. But I think there is an obligation, certainly, for the haves to reach out and to look at, see what they can do.
I think we don't realize the problems that are going to be facing the need to support our kids in schools.
We would teach kids how to ride bikes, and some of them had never ridden a bike before. And of course, the joy of some child who finds out that he can ride a bike, was like winning the lottery.
Any money that people give to any good cause, as long as it's well managed, is worthwhile.
Success is success, you know. If you achieve what you think you wanted to achieve, you operated successfully. We tried to do that.
A shy American billionaire is helping transform Queensland's medical research, and in doing so, he's saving lives.
And he's 81 years old. Few people on earth have given away more.
The reclusive philanthropist donated $27.5 million to the improved facility.
Queensland has benefited greatly from the American's generosity, which has seen him give away $6 billion around the world.
Well, Chuck Feeney, who you mentioned, is one of the great philanthropists of the age.
He is quite likely the world's most generous and modest donor. Chuck is the man who had it all and gave it all away.
The most important thing for him now is to spread the gospel of giving while living, and to influence more people who have money to give it away, and to give it away wisely.
Here was someone external to ourselves having faith in us, and the psychological impact was tremendous.
Giving while dead, you don't feel anything, but give it away today, you can see what it's going to do, and then you can modify your mistakes. It is clearly more than money. It's satisfaction that you're achieving something that is helpful to people. And I think you do get satisfaction out of something that happens on your watch.